God, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man?
A few moments later.
This shit, I'm out.
A few moments later.
Oh shit. Here we go again.
Oh Lord.
A few moments later.
Yeah, boy.
Cocaína.
Yeah, boy.
Hello again. Today I'm gonna show you four methods of farming stone in Valheim. I'm gonna compare them to each other, and I'm mostly gonna use numbers. I'm gonna farm a Greydwarfspawner and compare to farming those giant boulders in the plains, also farming stone in the mountain and farming stone in the Mistlands. Gonna use numbers, so I'm gonna compare how much stone you can get off each of these four methods. I'm creating a metric called stone per hour. I'm gonna see who comes out on top. As you see behind me on this character here, all this I have built using one of these methods. So you are totally capable of getting a lot of stone out of this. Let's start with the Greydwarf farm. Here you see me being too lazy to build an actual Greydwarf farm. So I've just made a fence around it so no other Greydwarfs or brutes or shamans comes into this area, where I can harvest the data or the amount of stone you get after 15 minutes. So what I'll do, I'll just use 15 minutes, killing as many of these creatures who spawn. Then I time it by 4 and we see how much stone you get per hour average if you use a greater farm. Let's just fast forward. If we time that by 4, we get 348 stones. 348 stones per hour. If you want to learn how to make a proper greater farm, I would recommend you just googling it on YouTube. Over to the plains. I know a lot of you guys like to farm these huge stone boulders. I do recommend it if you know exactly where they are, but if you don't, I'll rather see you just skipping over them. They are extremely rare compared to other methods of farming stone. Yes, they give you a huge amount of stone when they break. They only spawn in the plains, and not even all of the plain biomes has these stones. If, let's say, half of the plains have these stones, they may only be like 1, 2, maybe up to 5, 6 or something. And just be continuously sailing, running, walking, setting up portals all the time from plain biome to plain biome. I would say it's a lot of work for very little amount of stone. So sorry, I'm lazy, I'm just gonna skip over it. Okay, method number 3, the mountain. The OG place to farm stone. So in the mountain, I start by going to the highest point on the rock that's still connected to the ground and start hitting it. I'm cutting it all the way through, following the ground. You don't need to start from the top of the rock and go down. Most of the time the rock will still just collapse when the lowest part isn't connected to the ground. Sometimes the rock don't crumble. That's because of the game's physics. Sometimes a game thinks the rock is still touching the ground, but that's not the case, as you sometimes may see. Then I recommend you just hit the part that's closest to the ground, and if you can't reach any part of the rock anymore, then, I'm sorry to tell you, you just have to get on the rock and start hitting random parts on it till it breaks and falls down. I know a lot of people are scared of farming in the mountain because of the wolves, the drakes and the golems at day. I do understand. I was really scared at the start. I went up there with the padded armor, and back then I had the metal pickaxe. That was before Mistlands launched. I can teach you how to at least defeat the golem. When it comes to the wolf and the drakes, I recommend you to try and take out the wolves real fast. They do only one attack, and that's the bite attack. They are really hard to run away from. If you're really trying to avoid a wolf, I recommend you climbing up on a rock. Sometimes the wolves are insane and they still follow you up the rock. And sometimes the AI is so stupid they can't follow you just up a steep hill. To farm in the mountain, I really recommend you to have a portal nearby and have the rest buff for as long as you can. If you're really scared of the mountain's creatures, I recommend you have bone mass ready, so when there comes a lot of creatures that you're too scared to fight or need backup, maybe you're low on health or something, you just pop bone mass. If you've learned how to handle each mob in the biome, I recommend you switching it out with a queen buff. The queen buff does so your pickaxe does double damage. If you have a weaker pickaxe and weaker mining skill, you have to like 5-shot a stone. If you use the queen power, your pickaxe will do double damage and maybe you'll 2-shot or 3-shot the stone. In this video, I'm using the best pickaxe at the best upgrade, and I have above level 90 in mining. Mining gonna be automatically maxed just by farming stone. When you farm stone in the mountain, I really recommend you have a portal from a big storage where you can store all the stone and different materials you get from killing the golems, the drakes, the wolves. And the other end of the portal go to the mountain, and it should be really close to where you are mining. There's no point of placing the portal on the bottom of the mountain and then having to walk all the way to the top to farm more stone. Then go back and forth, use like 2 minutes of traveling each way. Have the portal as close as possible. If the portal gets destroyed by like wolves, golems or drakes, you should be really cautious and try placing the portal as fast as possible, because that's your backup. After farming stone for 27 minutes and collecting it and putting it in chests, I've got 2050 stone. That's quite the upgrade from the Greydwarf farm. But that's only 27 minutes. After 1 hour, you would get around 4,500 stone. It really pays off learning how to farm in the mountain. As promised, I'm gonna now teach you how to easily defeat the golems. If you don't know the secrets of the golem, I recommend you sticking for this part as well. There are two types of golems in Valheim. You have the one with the spike hand and one with the club hands. This golem has a spike hand. You can see that on the arm on the left. And the secret to golems that you can only parry one of the attacks. If the spike golem normally pulls his spike hand behind him, not turn around, just pull it straight back, that's a parryable attack. And after you parry him, I recommend you just quickly swapping to your pickaxe, because they are weak to pickaxe damage and only pickaxe damage. Then you can kill him real fast. The other attack you see, you can't parry. The one where he turns his whole body, swings at you, you can't parry that. You can try and parry it, but he will not stay parried for a long time at all. If you're gonna practice parrying the golems, you should bring a really strong armor and maybe some high health food, so you can risk taking a lot of damage. At any time when you're fighting the golem, I recommend you having enough health so you can take one hit direct on. Then you can just retreat, take a healing potion or something. Here I found the other type of golem in the game. This one has club hands, and it also only got 2 attacks, and only one of them can be parried. It's easy to remember which of them you can parry or not. If he raises one hand above his head, about to crush you, that one you can parry. If he raises both of his hands, you cannot parry it, or at least he will not stay parried for long. When he raises only one of his hands, You gotta be ready to parry and take out your pickaxe to be ready to do some damage. And now, the final biome, Mistlands. The Mistland biome is a lot more dangerous than the mountain biome. It has seekers, seeker soldiers, and ghouls as usual enemies instead of the wolves, drakes, and golems. They do significant more damage, and even having a lot of health, armor, and good weapons is not enough to easily deal with the creatures. After one day of farming, I have come to a conclusion that Mistland is maybe around as good as farming stone in the mountain, but if you perfect your method, it's maybe a little bit better. Maybe it's between 4,005 and 5,000 stone per hour. One of the biggest points why the Mistlands can be a little bit better than the mountain is that sometimes in the mountains, you're farming stones on the side of cliffs, and all those stones you farm will break, fall to the abyss all the way down in some other biome, in a black forest or plains or whatever, and you use a lot of time just running back and forth, mining stone and collecting the stones all the way down. That problem you don't have as much in Mistlands, since there's no mountains. In general, the Mistland farming also vary a lot. There are some huge stones, and when they break, you exceed 4,500 stones per hour. The times where one of those rocks don't collapse and you don't have it in your run, you're gonna have a little under 4,500 stone per hour. So it do vary. For me, I'm gonna start trying to farm more in the Mistlands. There's more stone in this area than there is in the mountain, so I have to move portals a lot less. Also, I can discover more of these huge bone structures, Dwerger homes, swords, armor sets, so I can break it down and bring it back to base. Those are really valuable resources for my build. You get around 4,500 an hour. This will vary a lot. I'll do a little recap for you guys. If you want to have infinite stone, I recommend you building a Greydwarf farm, but it's really slow. I've actually done the maps. If you farm 1 hour in the mountains, that's compared to standing AFK by a Greydwarfspawner for 13 hours. You can do 13 hours of work in 1 hour. If you want stone super fast, I recommend you mining those huge stones in the plains. But if you don't know where they are on your map, I recommend you don't do it. You will spend too much time searching. If you want a lot of stone and willing to lay in the work, I recommend you farming in the mountain. Bring a pickaxe, and if you can, use the Fenris armor to boost your efficiency. Over time you will get huge amount of stones. I recommend you to learn how to deal with golems, drakes, and wolves really efficiently. And lastly, the Mistlands. You basically get the same amount of stone as in the mountains. If you want to have more challenges when it comes to creatures, I recommend you just choosing Mistlands. You get different drops from the creatures. In the mountains, you get glass, wolf meat, and freeze glances. But in the Mistlands, you can discover new buildings and crypts. So this is the way I farm stone in Valheim. If you have any tips that I can use, please share them in the comments. That tip might save me a lot of work. I think half of my time in the game is just farming stone and wooden tar. So anything, please, please. Next video is how I used to farm all the wood types in the game. And that's it. Thanks for the support on the early videos and the criticism. It helped me to learn a lot. Thank you and adios.